In a previous video, Understanding the Importance of Proper Grounding, I discussed how a voltage drives electric charges to flow, and how a reference point called ground is defined as 0 volts. In this video, I'll discuss how to avoid ground loops, a common issue that can cause noise, measurement errors, and equipment failure. In a properly grounded system, all components follow a single path to the reference point. However, when 2 points in a system are grounded in different places that have different potentials, a ground loop can occur. In this example, VREF2 is at a higher electrical potential than VREF1. If the system is connected at both points, the circuit will be completed and current will flow between the two ground points, resulting in a ground loop. A common place for ground loops to occur is RS-485 communication networks. RS-485 is a serial communication protocol designed for distances of up to 1,200 meters, approximately 4,000 feet. Over such large distances, differences in reference potential can arise, leading to ground loops. In this example, a CR-1000X data logger and a CR-350 data logger are located several hundred meters apart. Each has its own power supply and is grounded to Earth, but the reference voltage at each site is different. I want to create an RS-485 communication link between them, so I use Device Configuration Utility to change the CR-1000X COM-C5 settings to RS-485 half-duplex pack bus with a baud rate of 115,200. I also use Device Configuration Utility to change CR-350 COM-2 to the same settings, and to make sure each data logger has a unique pack bus address. Now I'm ready to connect the two data loggers together with the 2-twisted-pair cable. Both data loggers are properly grounded with their ground lugs electrically connected to their grounding rods. If the cable connecting the data loggers together is wired incorrectly, a ground loop can be created. The cable has a twisted pair of wires with green and white insulation, and another twisted pair with black and red insulation. It also has a shield wire. I only need 3 wires for RS-485 communication, so I clip the red wire or tape it back at both ends. I connect the green wire to C5 on the CR-1000X and to TX2 on the CR-350. I connect the white wire to C6 and RX2. The correct connection for the black wire is RG1 on the CR-1000X and RG on the CR-350. RG is the resistive ground channel discussed in the first video of this series. RG channels connect to the ground plane through a 100 ohm resistor. This restricts the ground loop and limits negative consequences. In cases of large differences in ground potential, such as at a power plant, an RS-485 isolator may be needed. If the black wire were connected to a G channel on each data logger, the ground lugs would be connected to 2 different grounding rods and a ground loop would be created. Similarly, if the shield wire were connected to a G channel on each data logger, a ground loop would be created. The shield wire is important, but should only be connected to a G at one end, and the other end should be clipped or taped back. Using the RG channel and connecting the shield wire at only one end will avoid ground loop problems. A ground loop can also occur when resistive sensors, such as electrolytic tilt sensors, soil moisture blocks, water conductivity sensors, and wetness sensing grids are in contact with soil or water. The data logger sends current to the sensor through an excitation channel which returns through a ground wire, but the soil and water provide an alternate path for the excitation to return to the data logger. This ground loop forms a galvanic cell, with the soil water acting as the electrolyte. The resulting oxidation and reduction in the electrolyte damages the sensor electrodes, as well as creating inaccurately high resistance settings. Campbell Scientific resistive soil probes and conductivity probes are built with series capacitors to block this kind of ground loop. Resistive sensors without blocking capacitors may be connected to an AM1632B multiplexer. The mechanical relays in the multiplexer break the connection between the sensor and the data logger between measurements so that no current can flow. To avoid ground loops in a data acquisition system, here are some best practices to follow. Ensure all devices in the system are powered from the same source. Connect all devices to a single ground point, eliminating multiple paths to ground. Use optical isolation devices, such as the FC100, for communication devices when needed. Use RS-485 isolators and 120 ohm termination resistors as needed. connect RS-45 ground wires to RG channels. Use ground loop isolators, such as blocking capacitors, to isolate electrode sensors. Use twisted pair wiring to reduce electromagnetic interference. By following these best practices, it is possible to avoid noise, measurement errors, and equipment failure associated with ground loops and have increased confidence in the measurements.